Jeff Howard here at Kiteboarding.com. And let me tell you, you know, over all the years, we've constantly been hearing this, oh, this is a game changer, this is a game changer. Well, let me tell you, this is a game changer. This is really cool. This is the new Mystic Stealthbar. And I will tell you, the guys in the shop here are ecstatic about it. Once they got these in and got a chance to see these, they could not wait to get them in, and for all reasons. So this is it. It is a carbon fiber injected, it's like a plastic fibrous type molded bar. The really cool thing about this bar is they have it in two different versions, which is a surf and the kite. And what it does is it stabilizes the whole bar. They've really done a great job on this. And the reason it stabilizes is because, now this isn't, they didn't invent these little tongues that come out here. I've seen this before, but integrating it in with an injection molded foam pad here, which basically sticks to you, as well as it guards the bar completely. This thing does not want to move when fitted into the harness. Now, are you tired of clamping the bar in and having to adjust your straps every time? That's gone away. It's a game changer. You don't have to do it. Once you get your harness adjusted to you, it clips in there. So what it has here is a cam lock type clip. Now, the thing to remember, and I'll show you harness how this works in here, but this takes a two-strap harness, which is any to kind, all the Mystic, and it simply slides in and locks these tongues up inside of there, and when it's fitted in there, it doesn't want to move. It is really cool. So this is the surf one. Now the surf one, what it has is it has a slider, which everyone has seen out there, which is a great little slider. It's got a waxed Dyneema black, they call it their black Dyneema line in here, but it has the look, the ring in here, which you can hook into very easily, and you got your slider. But at the same time, this has got a display little deal here. I'm gonna remove it. So what happens is dead in the center there, you've got another loop of Spectra. This one doesn't move. So if you wanna hook directly in, which a lot of people are doing, they're not coming unhooked nowadays. They hook in, you will take your chicken loop, put it up through this loop. It's a little tight at the start. I was curious about that, and the guys here in the shop have put it through the test, and it kind of locks in, that Spectra locks in and gets to the right distance. So let's say you're out there, you're not an unhooked type rider, which is 99% of the people, hook directly into this. Now, when you're hooked directly in, you have to unlock the chicken loop and you hook into it and you're locked in. It doesn't want to slide, doesn't want to move. But if you want to go to the surf, you can use the same bar and then switch that over to the ring, and now you've got a slider. Really cool system. I'm gonna show you how it works here, as well as here's the kite one. The kite one is the same bar itself, and you can see it's got the holes in here for the line as well, but you have to have the back bar to hook the line in. So the bar itself out here, the molded part is the same, but you have a hook that slides up through there, so if you want the standard hook in here, but the benefit is this thing doesn't want to move. I mean, I've got it on a harness here, and I mean, the harness has got to move. This whole bar system will not move in how it locks in. So I said that you don't have to adjust your straps anymore. So these straps, once you get them put into there, you can hide these all away, and it's all adjusted. It just flops right out. So this tongue slides back behind. This is, I have it on a pyro harness. This is the Dakine. Once you put it across the power belt, then you simply get up underneath here, slide it in, put the cam lock through, and it locks in. That's it. Once you're adjusted and you're tensioned, you don't have to undo your straps and tighten your straps back up. Game changer, totally gone. Hide those straps once you're adjusted. You never have to mess with those again. But here you can see where I have the hold down strap behind the bar. We tested this to see how it would work also on the Dakine. And it works really well. So once you put your hold down strap, not that you need it, I mean, this thing is just locked in. They say it becomes, we're telling people what's the difference, it becomes one with the harness. It just locks in with these tongues that slide back in there. They stabilize the bar, and those are really stiff. So overall, you can tell this bar with the foam here, it will not even touch you in any way. It's fantastic. It's such a great little piece, and you want to get out of it, open it up, slide it out, and you're out. It's that easy. It is definitely a fantastic system. This is with it on the Mystic. There are three sizes of this bar. I'd actually say they have it in inches or whatever, but we got it small, medium, and large. Most popular you're looking at is going to be the medium. It will fit on just about every harness out there. That is this one here. This is an XL harness, one of the bigger guys here in the shop. It gives them just a little bit more space, the spread across, so with the harnesses a little bit wider. So if you go up to the large bar, I would say on an XL harness and up from there. But these things are absolutely fantastic. They're gonna be a hot item. We've already listed these things up and guys are going nuts over them. But once you see them first in hand, slide them into your harness. Again, they're a double hookup strap. So if your harness has two straps on each side that are, what is that, like a 1-inch webbing, you easily can modify it and use this type of bar. Anyway, if you have any questions about it, please let us know. But I tell you, that's a game changer, guys. Mystic Stealth Bar. This thing is fantastic. Anyway, it's Jeff Howard. If you have any questions, let us know.